darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. And great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour.
助我渴慕更深地经历你，更深经历你的荣耀和能力，求你显明你心意，提升我眼光，一天一天更新我生命，求你发出你的亮光和真实，
Hello everyone.
各位好。
Praise the Lord. Once again, we can worship the Lord together.
赞美神，今天我们再次的能够这样来敬拜主。
We thank God for this opportunity. With one heart, with one spirit, we worship our God who is worthy.
感谢神赐我们这样的机会，同心合意的来献上赞美给他。
Let's all arise.
让我们都站立起来。
Let's stir our hearts.
让我们眺望心。
Let's pray.
我们一起祷告。
Lord, we come with all our heart of praise.
主啊，我们带着感恩的心来到你的面前。
Oh, we rejoice for your abundant goodness to us.
主，我们要欢庆，因为你对我们真好。
We give you worship.
我们要敬拜你。
Oh, we give you our thanksgiving.
献上赞美感恩给你。
May you receive our worship, Lord.
求主悦纳我们。
May you come and meet us wherever we are.
主啊，不管我们身在何处，求主与我们相遇。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Almighty God, and that's who you are, Lord, because you have taken the greatest power and you have reigned. 主啊，我们要感谢你，赞美你，因为你是全能的神。主啊，你尊贵，你是我们的王。
For the weight of his glory, for the wonder of his grace, the power of salvation.
Forever he will reign, he won't be put to shame. 紧紧跟随你，我 主啊，我们要单单的来到你面前，继续的寻求你，继续的坐在你脚前，让我们能够站在你面前，瞻仰你的荣美，回想你对我们的那个恩典、怜悯、你的爱。谢谢你，主。We thank you, Lord, for your grace, for your mercy. And Lord, we say, it's no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. We want to serve you, O Lord.
Standing in awe of your grace, setting my feet in your way.Entering into your presence to behold you face to face. God of all heaven and earth, holding me in your embrace. Unfailing love that surrounds me. Oh God, I stand amazed. My Jesus, my Lord, you're the love of my life. Whenever you go, wanna be by your face. God of all heaven. truth. Clinging to the cross, I follow.
I say once again, my eyes set on you.
My eyes set on you. In this race that I run, no longer my ways. Let your will be done. Make me your servant. My heart's ever true. Clinging to the cross, I follow you. I follow you. I follow you. I follow you.
Hallelujah, Lord Jesus.
主耶稣，我们感谢你。
Thank you for this time of worship.
感谢你给我们这一段呢敬拜你的时光。
Thank you for your presence.
感谢你与我们同在。
Oh, we invite you to continue to move among us.
求主继续的在我们的当中运行。
Holy Spirit, come and open our eyes and our ears.
圣灵，请你来打开我们的心思意念。
Come and minister to each and every one of us, Lord.
主啊，帮助我们每一个人。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
赞美主。
So before I go on to my message, just some announcements very quickly.
讲到之前给各位报告几件事。
Firstly, just a reminder that these 40 days, we are fasting and praying.
那么提醒各位，我们即将要开始40天的禁食祷告。
And from the 20th of August to the 28th of September.
日期是从本月八月20日到9月28号。
So, in whatever way you want, maybe one meal a day, maybe two meals a day. However, the Lord leads you according to your faith.
那么按照呢圣灵给大家的这样的信心还有带领呢来进食，不管你是一天进一餐或者两餐，来各自自由的来向神来回应。
Let this be a time of us drawing near to God.
这是我们亲近神的一个时候。
Of humbling ourselves before Him.
来在他的面前谦卑自己。
And we stand in the gap for our families, for the church, for Singapore.
为我们的家庭、我们的教会还有我们的国家来代祷的时候。
May the Lord give you grace as we fast.
求神赐给各位恩惠，使我们能够禁食祷告。
The next announcement is about this Father's Seminar that is coming on.
好，接下来呢，就是这个为父亲而预备的一个活动。
It's 4 Saturdays in November.
在11月份，四个星期六的训练会。
Organized by Elijah 7000.
主办者呢是 Elijah 7000.
Free of charge.
免费的训练项目。
You will get more information in the WhatsApp broadcast that you will receive.
晚一点我们将会透过手机 WhatsApp 来给各位提供更多的资讯。
And we are calling young adults in our church to come together.
并且我们也在呼吁呢教会中的青成年人一起来聚会。
If you are aged 25 to 35,
如果你的年龄介于25到35的话呢，
We'd like to meet you on the 4th of September 8 p.m.
我们希望在这个9月4号8点钟晚上8点钟和各位有一个会面。
Take a look at this video.
我们就看一下以下的这个视频。
Hi Church, we have something exciting for you this September. If you are a young adult aged 25 to 35 years old, this is for you.
So it'll be a night for us just to hang out with one another, because you young adults matter to us.
No more high buys, okay? We want to get to know you.
Bring your kopi.
Bring your kerbok.
And bring your bubble tea.
And most importantly, bring yourself, because you are part of this family.
So 4th September, 8 p.m. on Zoom. See you there.
Praise the Lord.
赞美神。
So today my sermon is entitled The Taming of the Tongue.
今天给各位讲这个主题制服舌头。
Because this year we are talking about a culture of blessing.
今年我们在学习的重点呢是祝福的文化。
And blessing is about the tongue speaking words of power that's going to touch lives.
那这个学习重点就是我们的舌头发出的言语可以造成呢祝福，带来震撼。
And we want God to take hold of our tongue, to use our tongue to impact situations and people around us.
我们的祷告就是神来帮助我们，使我们用我们的舌头来造成环境中的一些改变。
So James chapter 3 verses 1 to 12 is one of the longest passage in scripture that talks about the tongue and the words.
雅各书三章第一节到第十二节，这十二节的篇幅当中呢，教导我们关于舌头的功用。
So let's read together James chapter 3 verses 9 and 10.
现在我们一起来读雅各书第三章九到十节。
Read with me.
跟我一起读。
One, two, go. With it, we bless our God and Father, and with it, we curse men who have been made in the similitude of God. Out of the same mouth proceed blessing and cursing. My brethren, these things ought not to be so.
我们用舌头颂赞那为主为父的，又用舌头咒诅那照着神形象造的人。颂赞和咒诅从一个口里出来，我的弟兄们，这是不应当的。
Lord, we come to you today once again.
主，我们再次的来到你的面前。
Lord, teach us.
求你教我们。
Lord, give us a teachable and a humble heart.
让我们有一个谦卑受教的心。
Open our spiritual ears.
打开我们属灵的耳。
Cause your word to come alive.
叫我们的你的话语在我们生命中发生果效。
Cause your word to speak to us.
主，让你的话语来触动我们。
Holy Spirit, come and shine into our hearts.
圣灵，求主来光照我们的内心。
And bring conviction.
主，带给我们一种的确定。
And let us be people of blessing.
让我们成为一个祝福别人的百姓。
Let our mouths will speak forth blessing.
让我们口中发出来的能够成为祝福的源头。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
So these two verses talk to us about our mouths, that we bless and then we curse.
这一段圣经节讲到我们用舌头来颂赞，又用舌头来咒诅。
Even as we want to learn this culture of blessing, we need to know how to tame our tongue.
如果我们要在这个祝福文化上能够有效的学习，我们必须学习怎么样制服我们的舌头。
Because we know that our words are powerful.
因为我们口中所说的言语是有功效的。
And every idle word we speak will have an impact.
那些所说的闲话也会带来一些的这个后果。
And James here tells us we cannot on one hand bless God, on the other hand speak bad about someone.
我们不能够这一头呢颂赞神，那一边呢又去咒骂别人。
So if we look at these 12 verses, James chapter 3 verses 1 to 12,
在这十二章的篇幅当中，
you find that it can be divided into four sections.
我们可以有四个学习重点。
The first two verses, James is teaching us about the fallibility of our words.
第一节和第二节告诉我们言语难免有错。
It's so easy to make mistakes with our words.
我们在生活当中说错话是常犯的事。
So let's read together.
再一起来读。
My brethren, let not many of you become teachers, knowing that we shall receive a stricter judgment. For we all stumble in many ways. If anyone does not stumble in word, he's a perfect man, able also to bridle the whole body.
雅各书第三章第一节和第二节，我的弟兄们，不要多人做师父，因为晓得我们要受更重的判断。原来我们在许多事上都有过失，若有人在话语上没有过失，他就是完全人，也能勒住自己的全身。
Yeah, and the first verse tells us teachers, you will receive a stricter judgment.
这里讲到做师父的要受更重的判断。
And that is a very scary verse.
这是一个非常严肃的一个课题。
Especially for us who are preachers and teachers of the word.
我们教导圣经的人更是如此。
And every word that we speak, we will have to account to God one day.
我们所说出来的话有一天要被神来这个判断。
That is very sobering. We have to be careful with what we teach.
我们呢在教导的过程当中要谨慎自己所说的。
But it's not just talking about teachers of the word.
但是不只是指到教导圣经的人。
Some of you are teachers in school.
好多人在当中也是在学校里面当教师的。
You may be teaching in a secondary school.
在中学就做教师的。
Preschool.
或者是在做幼教的。
Or a lecturer in a university.
在大学里面做教授的。
You are also included under this verse.
你也在这个范围之内哦。
Some of us, we make a living with our words.
有一些人在我们的言行当中。
You are a salesman.
就是要用这个舌头来工作，就是比如说是做这个行销的。
You are an agent.
是一个销售员。
You are a coach, you are a trainer.
或者是训练别人的人。
You are also a teacher using words.
你也是在用言语的方式来传教。
And sometimes we speak so many words. How to prevent a wrong word from coming out of our mouths?
话说多了之后呢，怎么样的来防止说错话呢？
Even if you are a parent, even if you are a cell leader, you are also in a way a teacher.
那么如果你是家长或者你是小组长，其实你也在做师父的角色。
So basically, all of us need to be careful of our words.
所以意思是说，大家都应该要在言语上更加的小心。
And it's so easy to stumble in our words.
然后我们在言语上过失呢，是常有的事。
Because James says we all stumble in many ways.
雅各说我们在许多事上都有过失。
None of us is exempt.
没有一个人能够幸免。
None of us can say I am perfect in my words.
没有人说我没有从来没说错话。
Whether you are a pastor, whether you are a father, we all make mistakes in our words.
不管是做牧师或者做父亲的，都有在言语上有过过失。
Even the author of James, James, he is the brother of Jesus.
就是这本书雅各书的作者，他是耶稣的兄弟。
He was the leader of the Jerusalem church.
在耶路撒冷的教会，他是带头的。
Jerusalem church is the mother church of all churches. You know that?
在耶路撒冷这个教会呢，是所有教会的这个母亲。
And even he say we all stumble. He is humble enough to admit that he also stumbles.
他谦卑地说呢，他本身也在言语上有所过失。
Stumble in many things, but especially with our words, we stumble.
在很多事上都有过失，尤其是在所说出来的话。
It is so hard to be without fault in our words.
在话语上没有过失是多么多么的困难。
We speak, they say, 15,000 to 16,000 words a day.
一般人呢说我们的说话的那个分量大概是15,000 to 16,000左右。
And they say ladies speak more.
然后说女性说话比较多。
And the more words you speak, the more chance of making mistake.
说多了就错多。
15,000 to 16,000, we make probably hundreds of mistakes with our words each day.
我们每一天说这么多话，或许我们每天都要犯上百次的这个说错话的次数。
That's why it's so hard to be perfect in our words.
所以在言语上没有过失是多么不可能的事。
And our words are so connected with our hearts.
话和我们的心紧紧地联系在一起。
Because if there's pride in our hearts, it comes out in our word.
当我们心里面有骄傲的时候呢，言语就表达出来了。
We're angry heart, angry words.
心里面生气，说出来就是怒气的话。
Unbelieving heart, unbelieving words.
心里面不相信，没有信心的时候，说出来就是不信的话语。
Jesus tells us, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks.
耶稣说我们心里面所充满的口里就说出来了。
Why is it so hard to control our words?
怎么会这么困难来勒住舌头呢？
Because there is so much rubbish in our hearts.
因为我们的内心里面存着很多的垃圾。
That's why we stumble in our words.
所以在话语上常常有过失。
And if there is a person who doesn't stumble in his words, he is perfect.
圣经说如果言语上没有过失，这个人叫做完全人。
Because his heart must be fully pure already.
因为他的内心就是完全的洁净了。
And so this is a journey as we want to walk in a culture of blessing.
这样的一条路径，我们要走向祝福的文化，是这个言语的这个过程是必须的。
It's not just saying a few nice words to people.
不单只是呢口头上说一些好听的。
It's what we do with our mouth from morning till night.
而是我们一 天到头来怎么样使用这个舌头。
And what we do with our mouth is connected with what is in our hearts.
我们怎么样说话是因为我们内心里面怎么样的来这个操作。
So cultivating a culture of blessing is being transformed in our hearts and in our mouths.
因此呢，这个祝福文化要转化的就是我们的内心，然后我们的言语。
And the Lord wants to bring us unto perfection.
主会使我们成为完美。
And the second section, verses 3 to 6.
第二段从第三节到第六节。
James talks about the disproportionate impact of the tongue.
雅各他提到呢，这个舌头发出的影响力呢，是不成对比的。
The tongue is so small.
这个舌头那么小。
But there is such a great impact.
但是它造成的影响力是那么大。
Sometimes we don't realize the power of the tongue.
很多时候我们没有意识到这个舌头发出怎么样的一个效果。
But scripture tells us death and life are in the power of the tongue.
然而圣经明明的说生死在舌头的权下。
Sometimes we think it's just a joke.
有时候我们觉得只是玩笑话嘛。
哎呀 it's just chit chat 啦。
只是闲聊嘛。
I don't really mean it, you know.
我没有什么动机，没有什么这个意思要伤害你的。
But we didn't realize our tongue has great impact.
我们却不知道当我们这么做的时候造成的影响力何等的大。
And James is very interesting. He uses a lot of imagery.
在雅各讲写书的时候呢，用很多图像来表达。
So it's very interesting. He teaches us through the pictures.
那么他用一些的图画来形容，来教导我们关于舌头。
Indeed, we put bits in horses' mouths that they may obey us, and we turn their whole body. Look also at ships.Although they are so large and are driven by fierce winds, they are turned by a very small rudder wherever the pilot desires. Even so, the tongue is a little member and boasts great things.
我们若把绝环放在马嘴里，叫它顺服，就能调动它的全身。看啊，船只虽然盛大，又被大风吹逼，只用小小的舵，就随着掌舵的意思转动。这样舌头在白体中也是最小的，却能说大话。
See how great a forest a little fire kindles, and the tongue is a fire, a world of iniquity. The tongue is so set among our members that it defiles the whole body and sets on fire the course of nature, and it is set on fire by hell.
看啊，最小的火能点燃最大的树林。舌头就是火，在我们白体中，舌头是个罪恶的世界，能污秽全身，也能把生命的轮子点起来，并且是从地狱里点着的。
So James gives us three pictures of this disproportionate impact of the tongue.
因此呢，雅各用三个图画来形容舌头发出巨大的这个效果。
Firstly, James talks about a horse.
首先他用一匹马来形容。
A horse is so strong, it is bigger and heavier than a human being.
这马呢是非常的壮大的，比一般的人呢来的重好多。
With a kick, you can fly.
他一踢的话会把我们踢飞的。
If a horse steps on a person, that person can die.
那么如果马用他的马蹄就是压到人的话，人会死的。
Yet when man put a bit into the horse's mouth, a man can control the horse.
只要把这个绝环放在马嘴里呢，一个人就能够控制这个马的这个动作。
A man can cause the horse to charge.
可以让这个马奔腾。
The man can say stop.
也可以把它勒住。
Turn right, turn left.
左右的这个转动。
The horse is under a control of a human being.
那么在这个骑马的这个人的手中的马是被控制住的。
Just because of this little bit that is put in the horse's mouth.
就单单使用这个马嘴里的这个绝环。
So that describes the impact of the tongue.
这就预表了这个舌头的功效。
The other analogy, James uses a ship.
另外一个形容的方式就是用这个船的舵。
A ship is so big, it can carry so much cargo, so many people.
这个船那么盛大，可以装很多的货物，或者是呢载人。
It's driven by great winds.
用大风的来这个吹逼它。
Yet it is controlled by a small rudder.
却被一个小小的舵来控制它的方向。
Just this small little piece of wood.
就这单单这个小小片的这个木。
And the pilot just needs to push the wood and move the wood, and the whole ship turns.
那这个掌舵的呢，只要轻轻的就是转动这个这一块木头，整艘船呢就会跟着转动。
In the same way, the tongue can have great impact.
所以呢，舌头就有这样的功效，会带来这样的一个效果。
And James says, "See how great a forest a little fire kindles."
并且呢，用火来形容这个小小的火能够点燃最大的树林。
On the birthday celebration, you light a candle, and that flame is such a joy to little children.
在庆祝生日的时候呢，蛋糕上都点燃的这个蜡烛，小朋友都很喜欢来用这个方式来庆祝。
But that same flame, you bring it to a forest, it can set a whole forest aflame.
这样同样的一个小小的烛光，你如果带到树林里的话呢，可能会把整个树林给烧了。
You know, we hear of forest fires in Australia, in California.
在美国加州或者是澳洲呢，都有这种森林大火。
Lives are lost, houses are burned down.
这样的一个杀伤力是很可怕的，会让人丧命，会让人家破，这个家园都失掉了。
All the firemen, all the equipment cannot stop the fire.
这些这个就是防火的设备呢，或者是说来止火的消防的呢，都不能够克制它。
In the same way, our tongue is that little fire.
一样的，我们的舌头就像这个小小的火焰。
You thought it's just a word.
你说呢？只是这样的一句话罢了嘛。
But do you know it can set our whole life on fire?
却能够把这个人的生命给这个点起那个火。
Do you know it can set your whole cell group on fire?
是能够把你整个小组呢点起这个火。
Do you know it can cause a church split because of this tongue?
造成呢，就是这个舌头的话语呢，可以造成一个教会的分裂。
And so James wants us to understand how disproportionately impactful this tongue is.
所以因此雅各告诉我们说呢，这小小的舌头带来的这个效果呢，是非常的震。非常巨大的。
This tongue is so small but so boastful.
这舌头最小，可是却说大话。
Very often our hearts are filled with pride and it just shows in our words.
我们的心里面常常有很多骄傲的态度，因此口里说出来的话就是大话。
We can't hide our pride, it will come out surely.
我们呢隐藏不住自己的这种骄傲的态度，总会表达出来。
And we live in a boastful age.
并且活在的这个世代呢，就是一个夸大的一个世代。
Everybody wants to boast. Everybody wants to show off.
大家都想要炫耀自己。
This social media, people, a lot of people, what they doing? They're showing off on social media.
在这个社交媒体上，大家都喜欢呢，把自己的所做的一些事情呢，让所有的人或者好多的人知道。
In the workplace, if you don't boast, sometimes you know you people look down on you.
在工作的效果来说，如果你不要把自己的工作果效说好一点的话呢，别人可能会轻看你。
So we live in an age where boastfulness is required, is accepted.
在我们活在的这个时代，好像呢说着夸大的话是必须的，是一个生活常态。
Even in the church, sometimes you know the pastor is boastful, and it is accepted. This is the way you know we run churches.
那么在教会里面也有这样的一个做法，就是呢，牧师讲话的时候呢，就把事情说得夸大一点，大家都觉得啊，这是可以被接受的，大家都拥护。
Because he is a pastor of a big church, got great miracles, so it's okay for him to be boastful.
因为教会很大，所以很有影响力，所以牧师呢稍微的夸大，这是完全合理的事情。
But this is not in line with God's teachings.
然呢，这跟神的话语不符合。
So this little tongue talks big.
这个小舌头说大话。
And James says this tongue is a world of iniquity and is set on fire by hell.
这个舌头是罪恶的世界，是从地狱里点着的。
James got nothing good to talk about the tongue.
所以呢，对舌头呢，雅各完全没有好的评价。
He says this is hellfire.
他说呢，这是从地狱里点燃的火啊。
It is our tongue is not neutral.
我们这个舌头不是中性的。
Our tongue has demonic influence.
是有这个带着邪恶的这个影响力的。
Set on fire by hell.
这是从地狱里点起的火。
And sometimes we release hellish fire from our tongue.
在舌头里面呢，释放出这个从地狱里发出的这个罪恶。
And when our tongue is defiled, it defiles our whole body.
当我们的舌头污秽的时候，全身就是污秽的。
Jesus says, "It's not what enters your mouth that defiles you."
圣经说，或者耶稣说呢，不是我们吃进去的食物叫我们污秽。
It's not about the clean food, that unclean food that defiles you.
不是你吃的食物是否洁净或者是污秽，然后影响到你的生命的素质。
Jesus says, it's the words that proceed from your mouth that defile you.
而是从里面发出来的这一个生命的果效，言语的方式，使我们的生命污秽的。
Because from our heart that is defiled.
因为从内心里面被污秽的话。
When we speak it out, our whole body is defiled.
口中表达出来，我们全身就污秽了。
And when you begin to gossip, 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 you defile the next person.
当我们说闲话的时候，听的人就被你污秽了。
And in a cell group, you talk, 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 you defile the whole cell group.
在小组里面呢，在讲闲话的话呢，就让整个小组都被污秽了。
And you can defile the whole church.
整个教会都被污秽了。
We got to be careful with our words.
我们所说出来的话，我们要何等的谨慎。
And it sets on fire the course of nature.
那么是在把这个生命的轮子点起来的。
That means it can impact our whole life.
意思是把我们整个生命会影响。
It can impact the destiny of our nation.
影响到我们整个国家的这个命定。
This is the power of the tongue.
这是舌头的效果。
In the next section, in verses 7 to 8, James talks about the difficulty of taming the tongue.
在接下来一段的第七到第八节，雅各他提到制服这个舌头的困难。
The tongue, he says, is so wicked and yet is so hard to tame.
雅各说这个舌头是罪恶的，并且很难制服。
For every kind of beast and bird, of reptile and the creature of the sea is tamed and has been tamed by mankind. But no man can tame the tongue. It is an unruly evil, full of deadly poison.
各类的走兽、飞禽、昆虫、水族本来都可以制服，也已经被人制服了，唯独舌头没有人能制服，是不仔细的恶物，满了害死人的毒气。
So God has given us dominion over the earth and dominion over the animal kingdom.
在神赐给我们权柄治理全地的，还有呢所有的飞禽走兽。
So mankind has tamed all sorts of beasts.
这些动物呢，人们都可以把它制服。
Mankind can tame birds.
鸟类啊。
We can tame reptiles.
啊，这个蜥蜴啊。
We can even tame sea creatures.
还有海里的这个海豚也可以把它制服。
I find it interesting that 2,000 years ago, James knew that humans can tame dolphins and killer whales.
那么在2000多年前，雅各已经知道人们能够去制服这些的海里的动物，还陆上的。
Indeed, this is the dominion that God has given man over the earth.
因为这是神赐给人权柄去治理这些动物界。
But unfortunately, man, no man can tame the tongue.
然而却没有人能够把人的舌头给制服了。
We can send astronauts to the moon.
我们可以把人送到月球上。
We can send spaceships to the edge of the solar system.
可以把这一个飞船呢，就是发到呢这个银河系里面去。
But we can't tame our tongue.
但是我们的舌头却没有人能制服。
No man can tame the tongue.
没有人能够制服这舌头。
Including you, including me.
这包括你。
This is the state of our tongue.
这是我们舌头的状态。
We think if we try, if we have self-control, we can tame our tongue. James says, no man can tame the tongue.
我们以为说呢，克制自己就可以了，但是雅各说呢，没有能力。
And this tongue is not neutral.
然后这个舌头并不是属于中性的。
James says, it's an unruly evil, full of deadly poison.
他这样的形容说是不仔细的恶物满了害死人的毒气。
Nothing good in this tongue.
这舌头一点好处都没有。
That is where we need to come to an acknowledgement.
这是我们大家都需要来到一个承认自己的状态。
We need to humble ourselves and recognize this tongue is full of evil.
我们必须承认这个舌头充满了害死人的毒气。
And we need to humble ourselves and say, God, help me.
我们需要在神的面前求主的帮助。
If we think we can do this by ourselves, we are deceived.
如果你觉得你自己可以克制你的舌头，那你是自欺了。
The prophet Isaiah, when he saw a vision of God seated in his throne,
当以赛亚看到神高高的坐在宝座上，
he said, "Woe unto me, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips."
他就这样的呼喊说呢。哀哉我灭亡了，因为我住在嘴舌不洁的人当中。
And the angel took the coal from the altar and touched his lips.
然后天使用这个坛上的火焰来 洁净他的舌头。
What shall we do with this tongue of ours?
我们这个舌头该怎么办呢？
It needs to be cleansed by the fire of God.
是需要被神的火焰来洁净的。
It needs to be nailed to the cross of Jesus Christ.
是应该要在耶稣基督的十字架上和他一起同钉的。
It needs to be buried in the ground with Jesus.
是需要跟耶稣一起埋葬。
Only then can God raise this tongue up to be used by Him.
这样的话，神才能够将这个舌头啊，这个恢复它的本来的功能。
So we need to come to God in humility and in confession.
我们必须在神的面前来承认我们的情况。
And this 40 days is a period of humbling, of sanctification, of consecration.
这四十天既是祷告，就是我们洁净自己，在神的面前悔改，恳求神洁净的一个时候。
When we come back to the blood of Jesus,
我们就到主耶稣的宝血里。
And we ask the fire of the Holy Spirit to cleanse, to purify our tongue.
求圣灵赐下火焰，洁净我们的舌头。
Because if our tongue is not purified, our whole body is defiled.
当我们的舌头不洁净的时候，我们全身都是污秽的。
Your family is defiled.
你的家庭也被污秽。
The words that we speak in our household, we defile our children and our family members.
因为我们所说出来的话的缘故，我们的家人、我们的孩子都被污秽了。
We want our family to prosper, but our words defile them.
虽然我们很希望家里的孩子们跟家人都能够这个发达，能够兴盛，可是我们却用这个舌头，我们所说出来的话污秽他们。
So God help us.
求主帮助我们。
And we thank God that God has poured out His Holy Spirit upon us.
我们感谢神，圣灵倾倒下来了。
On the day of Pentecost, the Holy Spirit took hold of the tongue and gave the gift of tongues.
在五旬节那一天，当圣灵降临的时候，圣灵用这一个舌头如火焰一般的降临在他们的身上，洁净他们的舌头。
So even as we have received the Holy Spirit, we have received the gift of tongues. Allow the Holy Spirit to control our lives.
因此我们来领受圣灵充满的时候呢，他洁净我们，他来掌管我们的舌头。
So every day, spend time in His Holy Spirit, praying in tongues. Allow the Holy Spirit to wash your mind and your heart and control your tongue.
那么按照呢，圣灵充满我们，说方言祷告，洁净自己的舌头，让主来掌管这舌头。
Finally, James talks about the incongruence of the tongue.
最后，雅各他说，舌头有不一致的表现。
Verses 9 to 12.
这一段在第九到第十二节。
With it, we bless our God and Father, and with it, we curse men who have been made in the similitude of God. Out of the same mouth proceed blessing and cursing. My brethren, these things ought not to be so.
我们用舌头颂赞那为主为父的，又用舌头咒诅那按照神形象被造的人。颂赞和咒诅从一个口里出来，我的弟兄们，这是不应该的。
Does a spring send forth fresh water and bitter from the same opening? Can a fig tree, my brethren, bear olives? Or a grapevine bear figs? Thus no spring yields both salt water and fresh.
泉源从一个眼里能发出甜苦两样的水吗？我的弟兄们，无花果树能生橄榄吗？葡萄树能结无花果吗？咸水里也不能发出甜水来。
The incongruence of the tongue.
我们嘴中所发出的这一个言语不一致。
With the same mouth, we praise and worship God.
我们这张口颂赞神。
Just like we did just now, praise and worship Him.
刚才我们才一起颂赞神呢。
Then we turn around, we scold people.
然后我们一转身就开始骂别人。
Isn't that true?
这不是真实的情况吗？
Does it happen to you?
这是不是你的写照呢？
Or is it only me?
还是只有我这个毛病啊？
Or is it only James?
还是只有雅各有这个问题？
On one hand, we bless our children.
这一头我们称赞孩子。
On the other hand, we scold them words that we should not use.
过后呢，我们生气的时候就发出一些说了一些不该说的话来骂他们。
I'm guilty of this.
我有罪。
And God forgive me.
求主赦免我。
Isn't it our mouth like that?
我们的嘴就是这样子。
On one hand, God bless Singapore.
这一边呢，说主啊，求你赐福新加坡。
On the other hand, we grumble about Singapore.
转身就在那边 发出埋怨的声音。
We grumble about the government.
啊，对新加坡的政府，对新加坡的生活环境呢，就是大吐苦水。
Is this the way to cultivate a culture of blessing?
这样能够造成祝福文化吗？
We know it cannot be this way.
我们都知道这不能够。
But we know the reality is this is our tongue.
然而，事实上，这个口中发出的言语就是这样的一种状态。
So today we need to face the reality of our tongue.
今天我们要来面对我们真实的情况。
We worship God, and yet we misuse our tongue.
我们这边颂赞神，那边呢就误用或者是呢滥用我们的舌头。
So worship leaders, worshippers, be careful about our tongue.
我们是敬拜神的，我们是领敬拜的，我们要更为小心口中发出来的言语。
Intercessors, be careful about our tongue.
代祷者，我们口中发出来的言语要很谨慎。
All who want to learn to walk in this blessing culture, be careful with our tongue.
我们凡是要在这个祝福文化里面来这个学习并且得到祝福的，我们都要小心谨慎我们的舌头。
It should not be this way.
这是不应该的。
Who can help us?
谁能帮助我们呢？
Is there no hope?
没有盼望了吗？
There is hope in God.
在主里面是有盼望的。
Does a spring send forth fresh water and bitter?
这泉源能够发出甜苦两样的水吗？
Can a fig tree bear olives?
无花果能生橄榄吗？
Can a grapevine bear figs?
葡萄树能结无花果吗？
No spring yields both fresh water and fresh, salt water and fresh.
咸水不能发出甜水来。
So we know that we are living in this dilemma.
我们就活在这样的一种状态当中。
And this season of prayer and fasting, let us be driven into God's presence.
这一次我们一起进食祷告的时候，我们要一起到神的面前来寻求他。
Let's come with honesty before Him as just as we are.
我们要带着一个真实的状态来到他的面前来承认。
As James tells us, there is nothing good in our tongue.
雅各说，我们口里面发不出任何的美好来。
Our words are fallible.
我们的这个话语很容易就会有过失。
Yet our tongue has such powerful impact.
但是呢，却发出极大的效果来。
It is impossible by our own strength to tame this tongue.
不能够靠着自己的力量呢，去把它制服它。
Yet God has called us to use our tongue for His purpose.
然而神却要我们用这舌头来侍奉他。
God has called us to use our tongues to praise and worship Him.
因为他要我们献上赞美祭给他。
To use our tongues to stand in prayer and intercession.
要我们用舌头站在破口处来做代祷的角色。
To use our tongues to declare and decree blessings and release and deliverance upon the world.
并且用我们的话语来宣告神的能力、神的祝福临到各个地方。
Use our tongues to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ.
也用这个舌头来宣传了耶稣基督的福音。
This tongue must be sanctified and purified.
我们这个舌头要被洁净。
And there is a way in God.
在主里面必然有一个办法。
There is hope in God.
有盼望。
Even as we humble ourselves.
当我们谦卑自己的时候。
And we draw to the cross.
我们来到耶稣的十字架。
And we cry out the blood of Jesus.
我们恳求耶稣的宝血。
Lord Jesus, let your blood cleanse me.
求主宝血遮盖我。
Holy Spirit, fill me.
求圣灵充满我。
Holy Spirit, touch my tongue.
求主来触摸我的舌头。
Holy Spirit, empower me.
求主赐给我力量。
Come, take control of my thoughts and my heart.
主啊，请你掌管我的思想，掌管我的心。
Take control of my tongue.
掌管我的舌头。
And let's respond to the Lord.
我们要向神来回应。
Let's arise wherever we are.
现在请大家都一起站立起来回应他。
Let's come with honesty before the Lord.
来到他的面前，来诚实的来面对。
Wherever you are, just arise and close your eyes and just let's bring our tongue before the Lord.
我们就是呢，在神的面前来祷告。我们可以闭上眼睛，把我们的舌头的状态带到主的面前。
Let's confess our weaknesses.
我们承认我们的过失。
Oh, confess that our tongue has not been consistent.
承认呢，我们的舌头发出来的言语呢不一致。
There has been mumbling and grumbling.
就是呢，发出这种怨言。
This complaining.
这一种怨声。
Faithless words.
没有信心的这种话语。
Skeptical words, judgmental words.
就是判断人的讽刺性的话语。
Scolding words, cursing words.
辱骂的，这个咒骂的。
Prideful words.
骄傲的话语。
Lord, forgive us.
求你赦免我们。
Lord, have mercy on us.
求你怜悯我们。
Let's come before the Lord to ask God's grace upon us.
我们一起来祷告，求神来帮助我们，怜悯我们。
Purify us, Lord.
洁净我们，主啊。
Oh Lord, we need your blood to cover us today.
主啊，我们何等需要你来遮盖我们，用你的宝血遮盖我们。
Oh, we need your blood to cleanse us.
主啊，我们何等需要你洁净我们的舌头。
Lord, we come before you at the cross.
在你的这个十字架前。
Lord, we bow before you.
我们俯伏敬拜。
Oh Lord, cleanse our lives.
求你洁净我们的生命。
Oh, forgive us for words that have hurt our brother and sister.
赦免我们所说的话呢，伤害别人。
Forgive us for words that have stumbled our brothers and sisters.
赦免我们所说的话绊倒别人。
Words that have defiled our family.
也说的话呢，污秽我们的家人。
Lord, forgive and cleanse.
赦免我们，洁净我们。
And fill us once again with the Holy Spirit.
圣灵，请你再次的充满我们。
Fill us today, right now, again, Lord.
主啊，现在请你再次的充满我们。
I surrender my tongue to you.
主，我把舌头交给你。
I surrender my tongue to you once again.
再次的把舌头降服于你。
Oh, right now, begin to pray in tongues.
现在我们一起用方言来祷告。
Pray in tongues. Allow the Holy Spirit to use your tongues.
用我们的舌头来祷告，求圣灵给我们这一个呢属灵的言语来祷告。
Oh, surrender your heart, pray in tongues.
把我们的这个心也归向主，我们用方言来祷告。
Oh, raba sharaba sakala la la ba sa da da ba karaba sa da la ba shiki dia la ba sa da ba so do 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 bo shiki dia la 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 la. Oh, raba sa da la la ba sa da ba shakala la la ba so do ko so do bo shiki dia la ba sa da la 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 la. Holy Spirit, come and take charge of our tongues. Come and take charge of our lives. Oh, robo so ko robo so ko robo.Oh, sanctify our tongue, sanctify us, Lord, and mercy on us, O God. Oh, robo sorobo shakala ba sada ba sekiri ala ba sorobo. Oh, robo sakala la la ba sekiri ala ba shokorobo sorobo sekiri. Oh, Holy Spirit, come upon every audience, come upon every hearer, come upon all of us in our homes. Holy Spirit, fill us afresh with holy fire, fill us afresh.Lord, come, let your fire touch our tongues wherever we are. Holy Spirit, help us, Lord. Oh, Rabba Sakalabashi, Kiriyalabasa, Rabba Sidi. Lord, we've come before your blood.
主，我们到你的宝血里。
Cover us with your blood.
求你用宝血遮盖我们。
And renew and refresh us.
更新我们，帮助我们。
We surrender our hearts and our tongues before you.
我们把我们的心，把我们的舌头再次的降服于你。
That it will be submitted to your lordship.
主啊，称呼你是主，你来帮助我们。
Use this tongue for your glory.
请你用我的舌头来荣耀你。
Use this tongue for your purpose.
主啊，为你的缘故，为你的旨意的缘故，求你使用我。
Let this tongue be set apart for you and you alone.
主啊，让我的舌头分别为圣，为你使用。
In Jesus' name,
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay, let's lift up our hands and let me bless you.
请大家向神举手，我来为你们祝福。
The Lord bless you and keep you.
愿耶和华赐福给你，保护你。
The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you.
愿耶和华使他的脸光照你，赐恩给你。
May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace.
愿耶和华向你扬脸，赐你平安。
In the name of Jesus,
奉耶稣的名， Amen。Thank you.
Thank you.